What do you mean by projectile motion and particle? Projectile particle. Find the value of the position of projectile particle at any instant of time. When an object is thrown in a gravitational field of the Earth, it moves with constant horizontal velocity and constant vertical acceleration. Such a two-dimensional motion is called projectile motion, and such an object is called projectile. For example, when we kick the football, it performs a projectile motion if air resistance is neglected. A projectile has a motion along horizontal path with a uniform velocity, and projectile has the motion along vertical path under the gravity with a uniform acceleration equal to g. Here particle is projected making an angle theta 0 with x-axis with a velocity v0. Suppose that the projectile is launched with the velocity v0, it makes an angle theta 0 with the x-axis as shown in the figure. Gx as a x on the body along y-axis and in opposite direction. Therefore, the acceleration a is given by a is equal to minus gj. Here ax is equal to 0 and ay is equal to minus g. The velocity v0 can be divided into two components, v0x is equal to v0 cos theta 0 and v0y is equal to v0 sin theta 0. If we take the initial position to be the origin of the coordinate system, then the coordinates of the points of the projection would be x is equal to s0 is equal to 0, y0 is equal to 0. If at a time t projectile is at q, then its x coordinate can be written as x is equal to x0 plus v0x t plus 1 half ax t square and y is equal to y0 plus v0y t plus 1 half ay t square and x is equal to v0 cos theta 0 t number 4 and y is equal to v0 sin theta 0 t minus 1 half gt square number 5. At q, vx is equal to vox plus axt and vy is equal to voy plus ayt. We get here that is vy is equal to voy minus gt and vy is equal to vo sin theta 0 minus gt. Here the equation 4, 5 gives the position of the projectile at any instant of time, and the equation 6 and 7 gives the value of the velocity along x and y direction. Define projectile particles and derive the equation y is equal to tangent theta 0 x minus g upon 2 cos theta 0 into x square. When an object is thrown in a gravitational field of the earth, it moves with constant horizontal velocity and constant vertical acceleration. Such a two-dimensional motion is called projectile motion, and such an object is called projectile. Let the distance traveled by an object at time t using v0 is given by x is equal to v0 cos theta 0 into t. Let the distance traveled by the projectile along a y direction is given by y is equal to v0 sin theta 0 t minus 1 half gt square. You can see in figure also. From equation 1, t is equal to x upon v0 cos theta 0. Keeping t value in y, we get here y is equal to v0 sin theta 0 into bracket x upon v0 cos theta 0 minus 1 half g bracket x upon v0 cos theta 0. Y is equal to x tangent theta 0 minus 1 half g upon v0 cos theta 0 whole square into x square. Here v0, theta 0 and g all are constant, and equation 3 can be compared with y is equal to ax minus bx square, which is an equation of parabola. Hence we can say that the path of the projectile is parabola. Hence we can say that the path of the projectile is parabola. Just you can see in the figure also. Here that is from O making an angle theta 0 with the x-axis, and here the path is shown, that is shape is parabola. Derive the formula for the time taken to achieve the maximum total time of flight and maximum height attained by the projectile. Time taken to reach the maximum height h be t maximum. At maximum height, the y component of the velocity of the projectile is 0. We get here y is equal to v0 sin theta 0 minus gt. Therefore, yy is equal to v0 sin theta 0 minus gt. Here 0 is equal to v0 sin theta 0 minus GTM, therefore GTM is equal to V0 sin theta 0, TM is equal to V0 sin theta 0 upon G. You can see in figure also the total time of the flight, that is that let it be TP. Therefore, substituting this value, we can get y is equal to V0 sin theta 0 t minus 1 half gt square, where y is equal to 0 and t is equal to tf. Therefore, here 0 is equal to V0 sin theta 0 tf minus 1 half gtf square. 0 is equal to V0 sin theta 0 minus 1 half gtf. Therefore, tf is equal to 2 V0 sin theta 0 upon g. Maximum height in projectile motion. The maximum height attained is shown in figure. The distance traveled by the body in a vertical direction is given by y is equal to V0 sin theta 0 into t minus 1 half gt square. Keeping here t is equal to tm, then we have to get y is equal to h. Therefore, h is equal to V0 sin theta 0 into tm minus 1 half gtm square. Substituting the value of tm as shown in equation number 1, we can get h is equal to V0 sin theta 0 tm minus 1 half gtm square. Therefore, h is equal to V0 sin theta 0 bracket V0 sin theta 0 upon g minus 1 half g V0 sin theta 0 upon g whole square. Therefore, h is equal to V0 square sin square theta 0 upon g minus V0 square sin theta sin square theta 0 upon 2g. Therefore, h is equal to V0 square sin square theta upon 2g. Derive the formula for range of the projectile R. Range is defined as the horizontal distance traveled by the projectile from its initial position x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0 to the final position where it passes y is equal to 0 during its fall is called range of the projectile. Or it is the distance traveled from its initial position x is equal to 0 to y is equal to 0 and final position x is equal to r and y is equal to 0 is called r. At any instant time keeping x is equal to r, then t is equal to tf, and then x is equal to v0 cos theta 0 into t, r is equal to v0 cos theta 0 into tf. Therefore, r is equal to v0 cos theta 0 bracket 2 v0 cos sin theta 0 upon g, tf is equal to 2 v0 sin theta 0 upon g, r is equal to 2 v0 square sin theta 0 cos theta 0 upon g. Therefore, r is equal to v0 square sin theta 0 cos theta 0 upon g. Therefore, r is equal to v0 square sin 2 theta of 0 upon g. Therefore, r maximum is given by v0 square upon g, where when sin 2 theta 0 is equal to 1, r is maximum. Therefore, sin 2 theta 0 is equal to 1, 2 theta is equal to 90, theta is equal to 45. If the object is at the angle theta 0 is equal to 45, then the range is maximum. And the value of the r maximum depends on its initial velocity. Derive the equation of motion of a body moving in two dimensions. V is equal to V0 plus AT and R is equal to R0 plus V0 T plus 1 half GT square. Consider a particle moving along XY direction with constant acceleration A at any time T is equal to 0. The velocity is the initial velocity which is V0 and at time T the velocity is V. You can see in the graph also, that is the velocity versus time, and the origin is 0, 0, initial velocity V0 t is equal to 0 time, and final velocity V at t is equal to t time. Since the particle is moving with a constant acceleration, the instantaneous acceleration can be written as A is equal to vector A is equal to vector V minus vector V0 upon t minus V0. Therefore, vector A is equal to V0 minus vector A is equal to V vector V minus V0 upon t. Therefore, V is equal to V0 plus AT. Writing the equation in terms of its component, therefore Vx is equal to Vox plus Axt and Vy is equal to Voy plus Ayt. Let at t is equal to 0, the position vector of the particle is given by R0, and at t is equal to t, it is R. The average velocity in time t can be given as Vo plus V upon 2. The displacement at time t is given by is equal to average velocity x, average velocity into time. Therefore, r minus r0 is equal to v0 plus v upon 2 into t. Substituting equation 1 in 4, we get here therefore is equal to v plus v0 plus at upon 2 into t v is equal to v0 plus 80, taking the whole is equal to bracket 2 v0 plus 80 square upon 2 is equal to v0t plus 1 half 80 square, therefore r is equal to r0 plus v0t plus 1 half 80 square. Writing this equation in terms of component, x is equal to x0 plus v0 xt plus 1 half axt square, and y is equal to y0 plus v0yt plus 1 half ayt square.